I'm here to talk about a zero friction future in automotive. And I know that may sound like a innovative form of fabric softener, but I'm talking about how we can remove friction from the auto consumer journey. So let's take a quick look. Technology has really changed the game for today's customer experience. Instead of waiting in line, people are ordering ahead on mobile. They're using augmented reality to shop furniture in their living room. And then with just a few simple taps, they're able to apply for a mortgage. But these are the same people that are spending 9 hours researching a vehicle. Car shopping can be overwhelming, but we know that there are tools and things that we can put in place to make it less overwhelming. The good news is that customer pain points tend to make the greatest marketing breakthroughs. That's why we work with Boston Consulting Group to identify 50 friction points in the automotive consumer journey, or as the way we'd like to see it, 50 opportunities to build an edge with technology. The first area that we want to talk about is discovery. It might seem like a no-brainer, right? A simple friction point that we saw at the beginning of the process that people were unaware that a model exists or has relaunched. Now this might seem crazy, but actually there are about 300 models now available in the US. And I know Tom will speak to this a little bit later, but that's a ton of models. And people that start actively researching vehicles, 73% of them only have 1 to 2 car brands in mind when they start that research. 77% of auto consumers say that social media can help them consider a brand they didn't consider before. And that's big, that's really big. So as we talk about a zero friction future, instead of people working hard to find brands, let the brand find the people. This is really unique in the aspect of we wanna make sure that we're pulling messaging upstream so that we're getting to people before they start their consideration list. And that earlier stat tells us that people aren't starting the shopping process with an open mind. A brand that did this well is Mercedes-Benz. They wanted a younger target to discover their new A-Class, so they used Facebook and Instagram ads to complement their TV buys. What was really neat about this is that the Facebook and Instagram video ads drove 87% incremental reach to their TV buy. So that helped drive costs down, but also introduced folks to the brand that maybe had not considered Mercedes-Benz before. Another brand that's doing this really well is Honda. They're experimenting with a new way to bring Civic to life in this new ad format we call Playable. This is a post-tap experience on Facebook, so someone sees an ad in their feed, they tap to it, and this experience opens. What's really cool about this, by obviously experimenting and taking advantage of a new format, is that Civic was able to reach millennial target buyer, and they also tapped into a cultural moment that we saw on Facebook, which was the resurgence of comic books in digital form. So very cool there as well. The second area is shopping. 80% of shoppers say that they want the process of buying a car to be easy, as convenient as possible. Yet simple friction points exist, like information is scattered, not enough information, product experience is not where it wants to be on a mobile phone. There's a lack of immersive things to do, such as messaging online or with your mobile device. So in a zero friction future world, we want auto shopping to be less stressful. And to do that, let's bring tools and information to people on the devices that they're using on a daily habit. A brand that's doing this really well and experimented with Messenger is Acura. They built a messenger bot to help people learn more about the TLX and ultimately get them down the funnel. This is a really cool build your own experience that was built straight on Messenger. So just like going online, you can look at colors, you can look at trims, you can look at packages, and ultimately the end product was for you to request a quote or to find a dealer. What was really neat about this is that it removed friction. It brought information to people on the devices and the apps that they're using on a daily basis. This next example is really working with immersive platform. This is a new thing that we just launched on Facebook, and this is actually the first AR interactive test drive. What's really neat about this is that it is also a post-tap experience. So in your newsfeed on Facebook, you tap into it, it opens on your camera. And the neat thing about this is you can entice a younger generation of buyers to interact with your product, explore features, and actually share this moment when they do record it to their friends via Instagram or Facebook. So let's go into another example to show interactivity. And I know you might be thinking, if you can see the gentleman driving this, he looks a lot like Jason Statham, but I will admit, this is me, for those that can't see in the back. But the cool part about this, and I wanted to show, it's gesture-based reactions. So I'm operating everything you see in that screen. So if we start at the beginning, I tilt my head to the right, it shows the right pan of the car. I tilt my head to the left, it shows the left pan of the car. I open my mouth, it makes me go faster. I smile, the lights come on. And at the very end, you'll see a disco ball pop up and it shows me bumping some tunes. So you might think, yeah, James seems like a pretty hip dude. Like, I'm sure he's listening to something emerging and cutting edge. But the fact of the matter is, I have two small kids and they totally rule the car space and the music that I play in my car. So for all intents and purposes, in this example, I'm truly listening to something cool and cutting edge. Another way to make this filter come to life is by adding, you know, campaign narrative to it. So in this particular example on the left, this could be a model launch or pick a particular element of the campaign that makes sense. You know, say it's an SUV and you want to showcase the adventure aspect of it. Or you're sponsoring a music festival or a sporting event or actually the auto show. So I think the really cool thing about this filter is that once you try it for yourself, you're able to share. And I think that's a big part of what we learn on Facebook. The third area is ownership. And how can we make ownership more personal? 86% of people say that they would like to have some engagement with their car brand after they purchase. But the friction points we see is that engagement is minimal and it's non-personalized. So in a zero-friction future, you know, usually the purchase marks the end of the marketing process. But in our case, the purchase is just the beginning. You know, to build loyalty, and we know right now it's at 50% for the industry, which is huge, and that's the third biggest purchase decision or reason to purchase right now. So adding personalization post-ownership will provide more loyalty and ultimately fuel more long-term relationships with those owners. A really cool example of this is what Turnkey did, the select group of dealers. So what better way to offer personalized messages than to remind people about upcoming service milestones? They worked with a set of dealers and used their CRM list to target people on Facebook that were approaching that service milestone. What was neat about this is that Turnkey Marketing was able to help dealers close over 1,800 service repairs, and they had a 3x terms of return on ad spend. So very nice in terms of reminding folks and getting them in to experience the brand more. So in a zero friction future, removing friction can help you get closer to your consumers as they shop, discover, and own your vehicles. If anybody has any questions about these immersive platforms that I talked about, such as the AR filter or the playable ads by Honda, I have a few product specialists here from Facebook in the front row, and we're open to answering any questions you may have. Thank you so much. Have a great auto show, and I appreciate the time.
James, thank you very much for kicking things off.